guys, it's me, Erica, and so today I finally brought a new DIY after like 3 months of taking a hiatus, and I decided to go out with I'm really excited for this DIY, and it's actually Sanrio Danshi inspired, which is an anime that is currently airing this winter 2018 season. By the time this video is up, I think it's around the almost finale of the anime, which I'm really sad about, but it's such a cute DIY to make, and it's not that difficult, and you can also display it for the springtime. So with that, let us get started. So first, the supplies you will need are wooden spears, a wooden wreath — I purchased mine from the dollar store — air dry clay, different types of acrylic paint, paint brushes and toothpicks, a variety of fake flowers to your preference, hot glue, and clear nail polish. And for the optional portion of the DIY, you will also need photo paper, twine, felt, and a hole punch. So first, we're going to be actually making the Sanrio characters that are featured in the anime: Cinnamon Roll, Little Twin Stars, Pom Pom Kitten, Hello Kitty, and My Melody. And I did this by forming each character around the wooden ball that I bought from Michael's. The balls that I bought actually had holes in beneath, and at first I thought that might have been a hindrance, but I actually found it really helpful in the formation and painting later on in the video. So the first character we're actually going to make is Pom Pom Pudding, and for this character I decided to make the cheeks a little wider than what the ball already offered, so I added some like cheek cushioners on the sides, and be sure to smooth it out. I didn't really do that for the rest of the characters. I decided to make like a little bit chubbier, and it was still okay, but I prefer the look of this one I did for Pom Pom Pudding, where it's all smooth out, because it seems a little more seamless. And after doing the cheeks, I decided to move on to the ears, and he has big floppy ears, so I just rolled out two balls and into logs and then attached it to his ear. And then after doing that, I did another ball for his beret, and then did a smaller ball to add to the top of the beret. After Pom Pom Pudding is finished, we're gonna move on to Cinnamon Roll, who is actually the mascot for my favorite Sanrio Danshi boy, Seichiro. So with him, it's a bit like how we did Pom Pom Pudding, in that he has cheek muscles, but they're a lot bigger than Pom Pom Pudding's, or I decided to make them a lot more bigger because Cinnamon Roll is a more chubbier character in the face region. And for his ears, they're about the same, just a little bit longer than Pom Pom Pudding's. And I decided to curl them out a little bit because of his floppy ears. I actually rolled out a sheet of air dry clay and then placed the ball around it to add a covering and some thickness to the hat, but not cover the ball completely because we're actually going to be painting inside of the face hole. Then after covering the ball, go ahead and add the ears, which again are just logs, and for one of the right ear, when you're seeing this, it actually is a little bit bent because her ears are bent and I wanted to add some more dimension to it. And then I added the bow. Next, for Hello Kitty, this was the one that was a little more simpler to make. I just added some of the clay for the cheeks and then made two triangles with two small balls and then squished the sides onto it to make it triangle shape. And then after attaching the ears, I made Hello Kitty's signature bow. And then for making the little twin stars, they were actually pretty okay to make. I thought it'd be more difficult because they're the actual humans for the Sanrio characters, but they were actually really fun and easy to make. So with this, I did the same thing with how I did the My Melody, and that I covered their heads. And then I actually did a scallop design for their bangs and their other hair by using a nail dotting tool, but you can easily achieve this by using anything sharp like a pencil top or a toothpick. I would recommend a toothpick just because you don't want to get lead into the air dry clay and kind of make it a little bit darker. And for both of the little twin stars, I actually saw that they had this little like ageho, is that what it's called? This kind of like hair sticking out, so I added like two small pieces of hair through the hair dry clay by rolling two small logs and then attaching it to the head. Then after that, you've completed the modeling process. But since I'm using air dry clay, this takes a while to kind of harden. I would say a maximum of 2 days to make it at least workable and not move in the styling process of when you paint it. And just a forewarning, I actually left these things to dry for like 2 weeks. Not because I wanted to see, but because I got busy while I was making the DIY with like school and stuff. But I think from experience, 2 to 3 days, it should be dry enough where you can work with it. And then when it's dry, go ahead and paint the characters. I suggest going on Google to find some reference pictures to actually color the to color each model. And here is a montage of me coloring each of the models. After I did the painting with acrylic paint, I saw that they were really matte and I thought they were okay that way, but I felt like I wanted it to be glossier, so I added some clear nail polish on top of it to add that gloss effect or something. So after painting them, let them dry for a while, and then we're gonna actually bring our wreath in. I bought this again from the Dollar Tree, and I was like, it's really pretty. And I also bought the flowers that I'm gonna be using in this video at the Dollar Tree, and you don't have to specifically use the flowers that I bought. You can make them your own. I just decided like I like the color scheme and fit a little bit more with my aesthetic, so I chose those. And before we start hot gluing some stuff, see if your Sanrio characters are dry, and then place them in an order you want. I decided to make the little twin stars the one in the middle since there were two characters. Mix and match the other Sanrio characters around the wreath. And then go ahead and heat up your glue gun and start gluing the characters onto the wreath first before you do the flowers. And for extra support, go ahead and use some hot glue to attach them onto the wreath. And by this point, I was like, there's something missing. And I decided to leave off the top space of where Pom Pom Puddin and Hello Kitty are and try to do something where I actually incorporate the boys from Sanrio Danshi. So I thought it'd be cute to add a picture in the middle. But this is totally optional. If you just want it to be Sanrio characters and you know what it means, go right ahead. But I wanted to add a little boiler of my boys in the middle of here. And by doing that, I just used some twine, some photo paper, and a bell to make it kind of a little more also wind chimey. Then after gluing each character, go ahead and start placing your flowers. And so for the photo, I just printed a photo I liked from Google and I put it on photo paper. And then did a hole, and then hole punched two holes, one on the top for it to be attached to the wreath, and one on the bottom for a bell. I actually had this bell from an old keychain that I didn't really like, so I actually just attached it to connect them all together. I tied some twine for the top hole and some twine on the bottom hole for the bell. After that was finished, I continue adding the flowers and then the berries that I had around the wreath. So after you assembled your final flowers, you are finished with the DIY, and I haven't been this excited to showcase a DIY in a long time. And I am very proud of myself of how this turned out, and hopefully yours turns out really pretty. I would love to see what you make with these Sanrio Boys, and it's just a perfect spring decor with spring coming up, even though where I live is really cold. But I would totally display this outside. If you are gonna display this outside, I would suggest if you're doing the photo to actually laminate the photo, because you know, I mean, I live in the Bay Area and it's been raining like nonstop, so your picture will be ruined if you don't laminate it. But if you're planning to keep it inside, which I am, to like decorate your room, you don't have to do that stuff. And enough of my rambling. Yes, you are actually finished with this DIY. And if you try this DIY or the many featured on my channel, be sure to use the hashtag ILADIYs on Instagram, Twitter, or Tumblr. And if you just want a fangirl about Sanrio Boys, just DM me on Twitter or leave a comment on YouTube, and I will gladly talk to you about it, because oh my god, I can't believe this anime is ending. It's blown my expectations on this anime, and I'm just like, okay. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and see you next time. Bye!